Hey guys and gals, I'm here with a new Transformers review, and today it's going to be on the Transformers Robots in Disguise Strongarm figure, who is just, there you go, and is ultimately a figure that just makes me feel sad. It really does. I didn't plan to get this originally because this is just, I was like, oh, what did they do? But I will say, my main reason for getting this is because this came out. This is the Repro Label sticker sheet for it. And it makes the figure look absolutely beautiful. So I'm covering this next, but that's why I got this. And this is just a reminder of just where we are in terms of Transformers figures. On the one hand, I love the fact that we have a Fembot that is not just a motorcycle or a slim down car. We have a truck, a big truck, and the figure itself is stocky. It's bulky. It's a welcome change. However, this is 2015, and we have just hollowness inside, very, very little paint apps. I'm not entirely sure how much of this is painted. I think that's molded. That may be painted onto white, but you can see there's not a whole lot of detailing in there. Honestly, I'm surprised there's even an Autobot logo on the front. I expected there not to be one. And it's just, it's so lacking. It feels so light, so cheap. And it's like, oh my God, this is what we're doing now. But at the same time, I guess it's being more aimed at children, and maybe they don't have a problem with it. But me personally, I miss the days when deluxe Transformers felt like they were worth $15. This one, it doesn't. So that's my big complaint out of the way. If you get this figure, I highly recommend the Repro Label set. You should get it. One thing that this does right that I do like, one of my big nitpicks with Transformers is when they have the weapon storage is just a hole drilled into the side. So you ultimately have, get out of there, just a gun sticking out of the side randomly just like that. I hate that. I do. And I realize it's a stupid thing to complain about, but I just don't. This one, it feels like it's proper just to have a gun on the roof like that. Like it would come out and shoot. This makes a lot more sense. You can have it up there. It can rotate. It can get multiple shots. You aren't limited to just having this one thing there. And the worst part is they usually have two holes. So you have one gun, two holes. It's a stupid thing to complain about. I get it. But I do like that. I do like that you can have a gun on top. And you do have proper storage underneath. Via this little hole in the middle, which has no purpose but for the gun. So, hey, good job. I like that. That's not bad. It does roll rather nicely. I say as this back wheel is getting stuck. I'm sure that's probably just my table. I'm hoping it's just my table. Probably my table. It's just that cheap plastic. But yeah, that is the overall vehicle mode. Just very, very plain, very, very basic, and I wish they had done a whole lot more. For a quick size comparison, here she is with Grimlock, so you can see just how they're not at all similar alt modes stack up. But also here's my go-to, Generations Nightbeat. So you can see that in terms of being a truck, she scales really nicely with your typical deluxe vehicles. I don't have Bumblebee or any of the other RID guys for a proper comparison, but you get the idea. So an overall, not a bad truck mode, just details lacking so much. To get this thing all transformed, all you gotta do, first, take out the gun. Just get rid of that. Now, I find it easiest to kind of just grip the back and pull it back just enough so you can pull this little hinge, this little bit out. It does stick really, really well in the back part. Once you get loosened up, that whole thing just opens up like that. You can go ahead and take her toesies and flip them out like that. And kind of this whole thing, it will unpeg, and you can even kind of take this and bring it up if you are so inclined. Go ahead and bring it up there and get it out of the way. Hey, it's up to you. And you can take this whole lower section and rotate it around. So that's facing forward. You go on to the front. You're going to break up this whole grill section, and that's going to fold down to be your hands. Those are going to fold up, and that's going to fold up. And then this is kind of, it's not a big deal, but I guess I should mention it. Once she's transformed, these little hinges are facing, you can see the pins are facing upright. You're meant to bring her arms down just like that so the pins are facing forward. And it's a very, very minor change. They don't lock in place, and it's ultimately kind of annoying unless I'm missing something. If these could actually lock in place, that would be a huge help. When the chest piece is up, it kind of holds them in place until you move the arms. You can see there's nothing holding it in place. If you actually place your finger on the chest piece and hold that in, I thought it stayed. I could have sworn it stayed earlier. Okay, there you go. It does do something. It's really disappointing. But you can take the shoulders. You can leave them down if you want like this, or you can bring them up. They are on these little hinge ball joints to bring them up so they're a little bit higher. Again, it's not a major change, but I think it does fit her a bit better, just to have her shoulders raised a bit more. And that is really it. There is Strongarm, all transforms, and, I do like that, for the most part, she does match her animation version. She does still have that stocky build. She still looks good. I like it. However, I hate this. I don't know why so many Transformers have resulted to this. I like having proper hands. And just having a fist buried inside just a chunk of metal that looks like she's getting ready to box, just, it doesn't sit right with me. I'm not a fan of that, and I think that's the only thing stopping me from getting the new Optimus from RID, because he just, I don't like this. Her backpack doesn't bug me as much as I initially thought it would. Yes, it is there, and it vaguely kind of somewhat resembles the animation version. She does have kind of like little wings that shoot off the top. I just wish there was a way to have the backpack slide down a bit so that white panel isn't visible right behind her head. Maybe have this whole thing rotate around somehow, so this is on the bottom and that's on the top, and that may give her that whole look that she has in the show. It's just But again, the lack of paint apps is really disappointing, and Repro Labels are going to fix that up, so I can't really complain too much. You can take her gun. It can fit in her hands, as a gun should, and I honestly can't tell if this is meant to be a kind of blast effect from the gun, or if it's just the tip of the gun that does something else. I'm assuming it's a blast effect. I'm not going to be an idiot and say, I'm assuming that's a blast effect, and I'm probably wrong. I am a little disappointed that she doesn't come with her pistols. I've only seen the first two episodes of RID, so maybe this gun comes into play later on the show, but I liked that her and Bumblebee had actual, like, pistols, because they're cops. They got their guns. I like that. And, yeah, that is ultimately Strongarm. If you want to take her gun, you can take it out of her hand. You can store it on her back via that method. Or you can take it, put it back like this. It's up to you. Or you can take it, you can put it like that. You can just have her shoot in the air. Me, personally, if I'm not using it, I just toss it. I toss it away, and maybe I'll never see it again. You can have her little flaps in the back hang out a bit more. They do limit her arm movements drastically the further out you go. Obviously, so I just like having them tucked away somewhat so you have that full movement. So articulation wise for her, she does have quite a bit, and I want to focus on the face sculpt real quick. It's not a bad face sculpt, but I am kind of wondering why they went for that versus the actual look she has on the packaging with the whites. Again, it's like, it's why was it that hard to put just some white on her head just to make it match a little bit? It's the paints. This is a little bit of paint. I don't know. There's packaging if you were at all curious. Transformation steps are on the back. There's no bio. You can play the game. I'm not going to show you how to do the game because I did that with Grimlock already. You scan her little code, and then you play her in the game, and you can do whatever you want. So, yeah. Articulation-wise, again, as I was saying, so the head is on a ball joint, so she can look up, she can look down, she can look left, she can look right, she can tilt her head. I thought she could tilt her head a little bit, and just kind of question why I'm complaining as much over a $15 toy. The arms are on ball joints at the shoulders, so you can have that full rotation, but that hinge will move with them, so try to grip that chest piece if you can, so you don't make a mess. It's just, whatever. They can swing out to the sides nice and far. They are on that little hinge joint, so you can have, you know, whatever posing you want. The elbow can bend. It can rotate at the elbow. There's obviously no wrist movement. She has a full waist joint, so that's nice. The legs can go forward. They can go back. They can go out to the side. They can rotate above the knee. They can bend to the knee. And she even has little toesy movement because of her transformation. So she is fairly poseable for a poorly constructed mess of plastic. But I gotta say, the charm of the character really makes this worth buying. And as many complaints as I have with the toy, I don't regret buying it. I don't. It's as I mentioned, it's nice to have a female Transformer that is a different body type, that is not just a motorcycle that turns into a really skinny body. It's nice to have someone that's a little shorter, a little stockier, a little beefier, and that appeals to me. I like that. I like having more Transformers that are diverse, and that's why I'm kind of excited to get Windblade, because again, it's not just a bike. and something new. Whether or not you should get this toy, it's very tough to say. If you love RID, if you love the character, I say go for it. If you have no attachment to the show, you just want a new female Autobot that is different from the norm, it could be worth getting. She will stand out and look a bit different in terms of your other figures, though. But I can see this being an easy pass for many collectors, especially of the adult variety, because there's not a lot of complexity there. But as I mentioned, if you do get this, I highly recommend the Repper Label set. I'm over the moon excited to put those on and just see how much it improves things. As it is, it's not a bad toy. It isn't. It's one of two figures I saw with the initial announcement of RID toys that caught my attention and I really wanted to get. And I am glad that I have her, even though I wish we could have done better. I wish Hasbro had done so much more. I'm complaining. I realize this is probably the most I've complained in a video for a long time, but I really wanted to love this toy, and I like it. It's a lot of things I don't like. And for a final size comparison, here she is again with Grimlock. She is, about the same size, a little bit beefier than Grimlock. And here's Nightbee, who it seems the more I transform, the looser his knees get. So that's fun. She does scale nicely with these guys, and I say pick her up. Just know what you're getting yourself into beforehand. Don't buy this expecting something that you would have gotten from Transformers Prime or Transformers Animated. This is the new thing that they're going for. So just keep that in mind. And I think that's really it for this video. I have complained far too much. And I am sorry for those of you who got annoyed by that. But I got opinions. That's why you watch these videos for some bizarre reason. But yeah, she's not bad. She's not terrible. It's just, I got weird standards. I don't know. But thanks for watching this video, guys. I appreciate it very, very much. And I hope you have enjoyed it somewhat. I will see you around. Take care.